Thank you very much, David, and Prime Minister, Secretary of State, my colleagues from across the NHS. One or two of you may have noticed that this past year the NHS has been celebrating its 70th anniversary. But today is not about the 70th, it's about the 80th. How do we keep everything that's so great about our National Health Service? High quality care for everyone, at a service that the whole country unites behind. But how do we also relieve some of the immense pressure on our frontline staff, going the extra mile day in, day out for a million patients a day? And at the same time, how do we capitalise on the amazing medical advances that we know are in prospect? Even just last month, we reached the 100,000th genome sequenced on the NHS. The first child in Europe got NHS-funded breakthrough cancer care CAR-T therapy. So that's the challenge facing our health service. It's the challenge, frankly, facing most industrialised countries' health services. How do you future-proof for the decade ahead? And that's what today's long-term plan is all about. We're able to do it for three big reasons. First, because thanks to the leadership of the Prime Minister, we have secure funding for the National Health Service over the next 5 years. And second, because there's a big consensus across the country and across the health service about how the health service itself needs to change. Since July, we've been working with patients groups, with frontline staff, with senior doctors, nurses, other medical professionals to answer the question what these changes should look like. And I particularly want to thank the patients groups representing 3.5 million people who've worked with us on this, including Age UK, the British Heart Foundation, the Stroke Association, Macmillan, Mind, Rethink, many others. So we've got funding certainty, we've got consensus about what needs to change, and the third big reason is because actually many of the changes that this plan sets out are already happening somewhere in the NHS, and now they need to happen everywhere across the NHS. So together we think this is a plan that is realistic and practical and costed and detailed and phased and, yes, ambitious. Some of the improvements that patients will see will happen quite quickly. New genetic tests for children with cancer this year. New options to see your GP online. Radical reforms to avoid 30 million outpatient visits. Guaranteed support for older people at home in the community. Some of these changes are going to take a bit longer. Halving maternity-related deaths by 2025. And some are going to require staged action over the next 10 years. As extra staff come online, we seriously begin to tackle health inequalities in some of our most deprived communities. And, for example, we're able to increase the proportion of people getting an early cancer diagnosis where their survival prospects are greatest from a half now to three quarters in a decade's time. We estimate that the combined effects of these changes could save up to 500,000 lives as we see further gains in the big killers and disablers of the people of England. Heart attacks and strokes, cancer, lung problems, many other conditions. But it's also about addressing unmet need, particularly in services such as learning disability services and autism, mental health services, services that for too long have been squeezed from the national debate and unsupported by the NHS. And all of this, of course, is only going to be possible thanks to the brilliant NHS staff. The fact is we are the largest employer of skilled professionals in the world. We've got 1.3 million people who are day in, day out looking after friends, families, neighbours. And we're going to need to better support them and we're going to need more of them. And so that's why it's right that the majority of the extra $20.5 billion in real terms we're going to be getting is going to be used to fund our current and our future staff. And NHS Improvement will be leading the detailed implementation work to ensure that happens. So patients will benefit, staff will be supported, and for taxpayers, the public, we're determined to ensure that every penny is wisely spent. Fortunately, we've got a lot going for us. We've got arguably the best value health service in the world already. The German health system costs one-third more per person than the NHS. The French spend twice as much as we do on administration, and NHS productivity has been rising faster than that of the rest of the UK economy. But we do still have opportunity for further efficiency, not only to ensure that the NHS gets good value out of the procurement deals and the medicines bill, cutting administration costs by another £700 million, but also an NHS that contributes to the economic success of this country, helping people stay healthy and get back to work, a vibrant life sciences sector creating jobs and growth, and not loading onto the costs of our exporting businesses through a tax on jobs, continental European style, the cost of running the National Health Service. So, Prime Minister, in making the important commitment that you did, you set us last summer six tests for the NHS Long Term Plan, which today we deliver on. And you also gave us the opportunity to identify potential legislative changes for consideration by Government and Parliament. And again, today we do that. So, having published the plan today, today the work begins to implement it. We're going to be setting out the funding increases that every part of the country will see in the next few days, and then working with local clinicians and patients groups across the NHS on what this will mean in every part of the country. And as we do that, we believe that this will help us put the NHS on track, fit for the future for the next decade. An NHS that works for my parents' generation, with more than a million retirees over the next 5 years, and an NHS that works for our children's generation, recognising that one in three girls born today in the NHS are likely to live to more than 100. So there are big changes here, there are practical changes here, there are changes that are going to be widely supported across the NHS, and today we get on with them. Thank you.